going to practice guitar. I have taken 3 clonazepam so far today. The third one I took after a nap, and because I had taken a nap, I took it later than usual, but I feel pretty normal. I've been talking to Melissa just about life and stuff, and it's been good. And I hear anxiety in my voice, which might be from the Coca-Cola, or it could also be because, according to the official schedule, I take my next clonazepam, which is anti-anxiety. I take the next one in 20 minutes, according to the official. Well, I made up the official schedule, but anyways. Do I sound crazy? Okay. Tell you that when you're not here, I talk to the camera.
Yes.
And so I have this problem where I'm talking to the camera and I get to a point where I don't know if I'm making myself clear.
Yeah.
Like I don't know.
You
if...
do not know who to ask.
Yeah. So I start to like sputter and like be like, I hope you understand, like something like that. It's probably good viewing for people who like watching Rex.
Rex.
With a W.
Oh.
Watching a lot of TV, and like I've been unemployed for, you know, not, I have had jobs throughout the years, you know that, right?
Yeah.
But anyways, I've had such like so long periods of total accumulated unemployment that I was getting to the point where I thought, like, I've probably watched all of every worthwhile television show that has been made in the past 20 years. And I don't know how I feel about that.
Oh well. There are worse things.
So where was I?
At least you haven't seen all of like Dancing with the Stars.
No, I know. But there, you know, maybe 100 years from now, television will be considered like how books are considered now.
Probably. In some ways it is.
So, like, it would be like, oh, they say with books, they say you're very well read.
Mm-hmm. You're very well watched.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah. I had a a social worker who was trying to compliment me, and she said, so it looks like you're turning into a movie buff. And I was like, oh shit. it's like saying to a fat person, like, it looks like you're getting good at cooking chicken, or like, you know what I mean, like.
Sort of.
If you're watching too much TV and someone's through.
But like, movie buffs are respected, you know.
Kinda, but I don't.
Ebert was respected, and he's seen more movies than like anybody else on earth.
Yeah, I know, but yeah. It's not my goal in life to be the person who has watched the most television.
True.
That, like, I think I, at any point in my life, I would admit to liking television, but I've never said when I grow up I want to, like, do nothing but watch television. I don't think anyone.
Actually, you know what? I think some kids probably
are like that. I when I was in high school, I was like, I wish I had more time to like play video games and watch TV and do the stuff I like, but I never said to myself, I don't know.
I want it
to be nothing but that. Agree that there's probably statistics to prove it, even that most homes have a TV in it.
Yeah.
But we actually don't know. We have not been in most homes.
True.
And like, there may be some statistics.
But then are tons of people just like lying and claiming they have a TV when they don't?
Well, okay, so like, say we get this statistic from the Globe and Mail newspaper. The Globe and Mail says 87% of homes have a TV in it. The Globe and Mail is owned by a company that produces TV. You see what I mean? Like,
I guess so, but I have very rarely seen a home without a TV.
It's just the thought pattern I have because of the fact that there are only 355 million native English speakers.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, everything you know, like, all concepts...
You realize that they do make TV in other languages, right?
No, I know, but I'm just saying, all concepts, like, all your science, all your whatever, cooking skills, everything, it's all based around English?
Not necessarily.
What else? Like, body language? Like...
No, but, like, translations.
What about translations?
Some cooking skills, for instance, and science. A lot of science is translated.
Yeah. But the original translate, you have to like, can you trust the translation? And obviously, if you learn, you know a second language, so you're more secure than I am. So when you say it's been translated from French, and then you look at it, and you don't understand all the words, but the French generally seems to be saying what they say the English is.
Yeah.
But like, for someone like me who, you know, I know a foreign word here and there, but for all I know, like, Chinese people, like, they say doesn't the media kind of present that China is a country that is, there's a lot of poverty and there's a growing middle class, and that there's some wealthy people,
mm-hmm.
but that's like the general,
mm-hmm.
but we don't know that, like.
That's true, I suppose, but I know some people who have been to China, so.
But what I'm saying is, like, if we knew Mandarin or Cantonese,
we'd still only know what was being recorded in Canada.
No, but maybe in Mandarin they say, like, oh, China's a strong country, America's poor, you know, like, that's just, like, how they...
Yeah, I get what you're saying. But I wouldn't worry about it too much, because I feel like, all you're saying, like, you're just kind of adding an extra dimension to the fact that you can't believe anything you hear.
Yeah. It's supposed to be making that clicking noise.
I think it's the pick.
No, it is the pick, but are you supposed to be able to hear the pick?
Sometimes, yeah. And you're right on top of it, right? Like, you gotta keep in mind that when you hear people play, like, in recordings or in concerts or whatever, like, you're too far away to hear the actual...
Yeah.
I was listening to Elliot Smith the other day. What else is new? And, like, you can hear his fingers squeak on the string sometimes, and I just love that.
I guess it's very important for us to have dead rock stars. So when you say you're obsessed with Elliot Smith, I have no fear of you leaving me for him.
So what you're saying is not that it's important we have dead rock stars. You're saying that it's important that rock stars all be dead.
Oh, eventually we'll get to them.
Get an album released, you had to, like, immediately be put to death. Like,
no, I think there is actually genuine cover-ups. I think enough money is involved in, like, movie stars and music stars. Like, Michael Jackson could very well be alive, and I don't think that's paranoid or delusional. Like, the guy made, like, I'm sure he made at least $1 billion.
I kind of think Tupac is still alive because he keeps releasing music.
Yeah, no, like, they definitely can still be alive. Like, they've made enough money that they can fake their death.
Maybe Richie is still alive. I don't think so.
Sorry, yeah. Okay. I became such a great guitarist that Richie sought me out and was like, shh, you're Grove, don't tell anyone. I used to be the Manic Street Preachers.
And Richie doesn't know how to play guitar.
No, but I'm just like such a great guitarist that I'm sure he at least appreciates guitar.
Yeah.
Anyway.
It was more like his three best friends were in a band, so he was like, I guess I'll be in a band.
Okay. Well then, I'm just so cool.
Okay. You are so cool.
I'm just so cool that Richie finds me.
I would be very mad if you didn't tell me.
No, but then I say to him, you have to come meet this person.
Yes.
And what if I'm hypnotizing you so you will stay with me forever because you believe this is actually going to happen?
Yeah, I do believe it now. Actually, I knew this was going to happen from the first time I met you. I sought you out. You are Richie, aren't you?
Yes. You like my plastic surgery?
You look very rich.
How old am I?
I don't know, you were born in 1967.
Shit, man. So I'm like 47. Person.
Yes.
Like, there's not a, I don't remember really people making fun of 30-year-olds, like 30 to 39, I don't, like 30-somethings.
Mm-hmm.
I don't remember, there wasn't too much of like, oh, he's 30, but what, you know, but 40-year-olds definitely, 50-year-olds, I think that's more just like pity. And then 60-year-old, I don't know, what do you think the general opinion of...
I don't know, man.
Anyways, my point is, like, when we grow up, we make fun of older people, and then we become that age, and all the...
And like, then you make fun of children.
No, but like, all the negative things you said about, like, 40-year-olds, like, when you turn 40, you remember you saying those, that it's you?
Yeah.
I'll stop working on that. Accomplished anything in my life?
Yeah, many things.
What?
Nothing tangible. Nothing to put your finger on.
Isn't that kind of bad?
No.
Can you talk me through this?
Most people don't accomplish anything big and tangible other than maybe having a kid. And I actually don't really think having a kid is an accomplishment.
Well, it takes work.
If you're a good parent.
Oh, yeah.
That's my point.
I understand that.
Yeah. Most people, it's more like small day-to-day things that you can't really just be like, here is one thing I accomplished today. Yeah. You know, it's like, you've accomplished tons of stuff, but they're not stuff you can just name.
It's not, I wasn't in Star Wars.
Yeah. Yeah.
Meanwhile, the guy who was in Star Wars, like, literally murdered someone and got away with it because he's in Star Wars and they can't send him to jail.
Oh, Mark Hamill?
I made that up.
Oh, okay.
but the point being, like, the people that we look up to who, like, did something, they could be, like, horrible, horrible people.
And many of them actually are. I think you should start that rumor.
That Mark Hamill killed someone?
Yes. Mark Hamill killed someone.
I don't know how you use the Twitter hashtag. You know, that's
hashtag Mark Hamill killed someone.